My name is Nate.
Yeah. Where are you calling from?
So I'm from in Thailand.
Where are you from? Are you from Thailand originally?
Oh, no. I'm from Myanmar.
Well, Nay, welcome to talk to us. I'm Avi Arditi from VOA Learning English, and yeah. I'm here in Seoul, South Korea, joined by two English teachers.
Hello, Nay. I'm Seoul Yimun, and I'm from Myanmar.
Yes, me too. Yeah, nice to meet you.
And I'm Hung from Vietnam.
Sometimes I'm using the present participle and a past participle. Sometimes it makes me difficult to understand. Especially the past participle.
So I'll give us an example of the past participle and the present participle. So a sentence where that's being used so people can understand what he's talking about.
Well, it's only a matter of tenses because as you said, participle, to make you more understand, you are talking about the ING form, am I right?
Yeah.
ING
yep.
form. We call it ING form in our country.
Sure.
So,
yeah.
Yes, so what... that the action you are doing at the moment, we use the present participle, like I am eating, I am talking to you, I am writing a letter. But this action is happened in the past. We use I was writing, I was reading, I was listening. But
yeah.
In that sense, there should be another action happening at the same time. You were talking to someone else while you were reading the newspaper, something like that. So there's two action happening at the same time in the past.
And so an example, present participle, you're saying, I am eating.
Yes,
right. And then
now.
Past participle would be...
I was eating. But this structure, this grammar structure is used when two actions happening at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
I was eating while I was doing this and that. Something like
I
that.
Was eating while I was
but,
talking.
Yes, while I was because if you want to see the past action happened in the past, you usually use past tense. I read newspaper.
Yeah.
Yesterday, but you can use I was reading a newspaper yesterday while my mother came into my house or when my mother called me.
Sometimes you know like a person. Who made the two actions in the same time,
yes.
Like a ever. Now, yeah, we use like ever. But in fact, the present participle, it doesn't make me complex. But
yes.
Actually, the past participle.
Yes, past participle.
Yeah, sometimes.
Because some people confuse whether to use the past tense or the past
yeah.
participle. So
yeah,
there is only one action, you just use the simple past tense. But
I read the newspaper. But if it was, I read the newspaper while watching television,
yes.
then you would use the ing.
Yes.
But if you were only doing one thing, I read the newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
The past tense and the ing participle?
Yes.
The difference is that when we talk about the completed action
mm-hmm.
in the past, we use the past tense. For example, I read a very interesting book yesterday. But when we focus on the, when we focus on the action that something is in progress
mm-hmm.
at a particular time in the past, we use the imparticiple, it's the ing. Yes, for example, I was having dinner at 7 p.m. yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
So the action is in the progress.
I can't learn grammar. My pronunciation can't improve every day. And the second, I want to learn more vocabulary, but I can't. It's so hard to remember and have a lot of vocabulary. I want to ask you, do you have a skill or something like that to learn vocabulary? It's easier.
Do you have any suggestions for...
In my country, Burma, we use the vocabulary books written by Raymond Murphy. They come from elementary level, intermediate level, advanced level. So different levels. So if you can find these books with the author name Raymond Murphy, then I think it's the ideal. You can start with the elementary one, then you can move on to the advanced levels. That's my suggestion.
Yes, when you learn vocabulary, you should learn it in context. Do you have any difficulties or problems learning English?
Yes.
What is your biggest problem?
I think it's about speaking.
Speaking?
Yes.
Are there any strategies you would recommend?
Yes. How often do you speak in English?
Not much. I don't have a friend that speak in it. So I'm just watching movie to improve my speaking. I'm usually watching movie with a subtitle.
Try to focus listening when you watch the movies, because the more you listening, and you will be able to improve your speaking skills.
How has it been for you learning English? Is it hard? Is it easy?
Yes, sometimes hard, sometimes easy.
Where do you learn English?
Yeah. I learned by myself and from internet.
Good.
And I reading from your practice in Facebook.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad it's been helpful.
I'm learning also from internet and by myself. And now I'm get learning about German language.
Now, English has a lot of words from German. Do you find that the English you've learned is helping you study German?
Yeah. Because that's my teacher from the Germans. Use English also to explain to us.
Are you planning to go to Germany? Or how did you pick German as your next language?
No, just I want to know, because I see that Germany is so complicated, so I want to know why like that. But in English, all people know about English, yeah?
Uh-huh.
So I want to try Germany language.
Interesting, because you're saying because everyone is learning English, you want to learn something different.
Yeah.
I want to have a plan for learning English with you.
Firstly, you should think about your goal of learning English. So first, start with your goal. Which level and what do you want to achieve? And then you can consider how much time do you have a day to reach that goal.
Do you want to focus on speaking or listening? Huang just talked about a goal.
Yes.
Setting a goal. What goal do you want to reach in terms of learning English?
Speaking or reading, writing, or just listening?
I am a nurse practitioner, and many of my textbook is in English language. I want to read my book completely and understand them.
How much of your books do you currently understand?
About 70%.